We never ever thought of it as a disability, we always thought of it as a difference. We had a job provider and they, in 12 months, didn't even get us one interview. And the people there were an absolute mixed bag. They were sometimes bullying. The odd one would try and help. Just didn't know what we were going to do.
New person every week.
Yeah.
All the job searching and interviews and all that, it's basically all just one giant sorting algorithm, which is not optimized for people with Asperger's and autism, just to put it plainly. Job seeking companies would typically be go find work and maybe get them to secure some interviews for us. But I pretty much had one requirement, which was I'm not very good at like listening to people over the phone. I can barely hear them. And of course, that's pretty much all that they came up with.
You think you've got people on your side and then nobody's really trying to help you.
Yeah, with DXC, that there was a clear-cut path from the beginning and a selection process which involved actually going into your technical ability and just, you know, getting instant feedback, being in the actual environment, completely different to an actual interview process.
Yeah, it was very clear-cut. You knew exactly what he had to do and it was tapping into his skills. And it was in a, you know, it wasn't the classic interview.
ANZ runs a program with DXC Technology where we put the candidates through a workshop in a 3-week assessment period where we get to see their true abilities. That they all have this talent, but they don't really know where they fit in and what they can achieve. By training and learning, it really exposes that ability in them and they really pick up things so quick. When our first group of candidates came in, we put them all through financial literacy on the Money Minded program. After about 2 months, Richard actually moved out of home. So not only slashing his commute time from hours to minutes, really changed the way his life was at home. He's now living in more independently and it's changed his parents' lives, who now can support him outside of home.
Yeah, I want to live my life, of course, so. But obviously, you know, I'm quite invested in my work and I want to get better at it. But the prospect of what's called financial independence is quite a nice idea.
The main thing is that he's feels valued, I think, where he's working. He's now got a lot more confidence. He seems more capable, he has more initiative. Living away from home is a huge step, which I thought would never come, but there he is. But as a family, I think just the knowledge that he's got a career and that he will be financially secure is huge. So it gives him so many options that he never had before.
One thing that a lot of people, I suppose, in my position or something, all they really want is just that first step to get into the workplace. A lot of them, you know, just they, for one reason or another, they don't want to be known as the person with autism in their workplace. They may just have difficulties with getting into the workplace in the first place. You know, they want minimal support and essentially want to be treated like everyone else. I'm just me.